Hello. For those who don't know me, my name is Paul and I am a mindset coach. I help entrepreneurs essentially get out of their own way, find out where they're procrastinating, struggling with perfectionism, feeling overwhelmed, get rid of all that, and help them become more confident in themselves and their business. Today, I want to talk about, well, I want to answer this question actually. How do I fix my broken life? A couple of people have asked me this question recently. Well, not quite in those specific words, but very similar. The thing is, you need to remember your most important asset is your mindset. Mindset is everything. So if you go around saying that, oh, my life is broken, this is broken, I'm crap at this, I'm crap at that, then your mind takes you where you want to go. So if you're thinking negativity or negative things about yourself all the time, guess what? Your brain goes, okay, Paul wants to feel negative and sad and woe is me today. That's what we'll give him. And that's what you get. Your whole outlook becomes dark and dour and dank and nasty and yeah? So the first thing we need to do is, okay, accept that things aren't perfect right now. That's the first step, okay? Accept it. Don't hide under the pillows. Don't run away. Don't pretend things are great. Yeah, accept that the situation isn't perfect. That is the first step. And if you do that, you're streets ahead of most people, because a lot of people will ignore what's, you know, the evidence that's right in front of their face. They'll pretend it's not happening. So if you can do that, if you can accept the situation, that is brilliant. You're one step ahead already. The next thing to do is to, how can I put this? Take stock of your situation. You know, like if you are doing an inventory in a store, you work out how many cans this, how many boxes of that, how many tubes of the other you've got, and you build an inventory of the stock that you've got. So you need to take an inventory of yourself. Your whole life isn't broken. Maybe one or two parts, or even three parts might be broken, but it's not broken. You're in a situation that isn't working or hasn't worked or has stopped. That's what we need to look at, okay? Your whole life isn't a mess. So we need to bring it down to the bit that isn't working, and that's where we put our focus. So you may have lost your job. You may have lost the love of your life even. You may have been married for 25 years and she or he has just said, that's it, I'm walking. Yeah, those situations are devastating, but the only way to deal with them is to look at the situation for what it is and then take action. Sitting there thinking, oh my God, how could you leave me after 25 years? I thought we were in love with each other. We were childhood sweethearts. People change, circumstances change, we change. It happens every single day of the week. So focusing on what isn't working, and that's where we need to make the start. Yeah. The next thing you need to do is to stop looking backwards. Stop looking at what you think you did wrong, why it didn't work out, why, you know, after all this time we had the beautiful holidays, the business was flourishing, this was going well, that was going well, and it's not. Stop doing that. Stop looking backwards. You can't turn back the clock. You can't go back in time. You know, I know Back to the Future and the DeLorean made it seem possible, but there ain't a time machine. And even if there was, you probably wouldn't want to go back and change it, because any time change that you made would probably have some kind of negative effect today. So stop looking backwards. What we need to do is look at where we are right now, okay? Don't actually even look forward, because if you look forward to the future, can you predict the future? Are you a mind reader? Do you have the telepathic skills? Do, 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 do. None of us do. Even people that are, you know, clairvoyants and healers, nobody can look into the future. You can make a best guess, you can estimate, you can look at the situation and, you know, make notes, but you don't know the future. You are here right now in this moment. That's what you need to take stock of. Where am I right now? What can I do right now to make things happen, to move things forward, to make the changes I need to make, to stop this feeling of being broken? For example, change your mindset. If you're a person that has a closed mindset, that sees everything as black and white, no options, no opportunities, nothing's working, then yeah, that's all you're going to see. So look to becoming more open-minded, more broad-minded, thinking that, you know, start be thinking that there are opportunities, there are other people out there are other things you can do, there are other jobs, there are other businesses. Start looking towards the positive side of life. Yes, shit will still happen, because that's what life does. I was talking to a friend of mine yesterday, and she was saying to me, I was never ever have guessed that at this age that I am now, I'd have to move back in with my mum. Yeah. And this lady is, you know, mid 40s, I'll be polite, okay? And she just said, you know, this situation's changed and I've got to move back in with my mum. Who would have thought it? Well, okay, yeah, it's happened. You've got to move back in with mum. But guess what? You've got a mum to move back in. Your mum's got a house. Mum's got space. Mum is willing to take you in. A lot of people don't have that resource, for want of a better word, yeah? So be lucky that you have that situation to do, that you have got a fallback, okay? A lot of people don't. Take stock of your situation and start to become more open-minded, more broad-minded, more optimistic about your life. Your life isn't broken. A certain part of it has stopped working temporarily. That is it. The next thing we need to do, the final thing, is to take action. Do something. Don't sit there. Don't wallow. Get up. Go take a shower. Start writing, redoing your resume. Get somebody to do it for you. Start looking at another rewind. Start looking for other opportunities. Get back on dating sites. Whatever isn't working, start to fix it. But Paul, I can't, because I'm still feeling sorry for myself because this happened and I wasn't expecting it. Okay, look, it's happened, it's gone, it's done, it's over. Pack it in, yeah? Give yourself the 5-minute pity party, then start moving forward. Now, I'm not meaning to be harsh here. This is a tough love, okay? But we need to move forward. I have wallowed. I've spent years wallowing in self-pity. I can remember times when I've got jealous because my best mate has got promoted and has gone forward and is now flying high and doing amazing things. But when I look at why and how he got promoted, he was working his ass off. He was doing courses on his days off, on holidays. He was going and working and doing different things. He was doing everything I wasn't doing. But I felt self-pity. I wallowed in it because he was moving forward and I wasn't. Okay? And I recognized why over time. But for the longest time, I felt so sorry for myself. I had a 5-year-long pity party, maybe even more than that. And that is bad. A 5-year-long pity party, feeling sorry for myself. At one stage, it got so bad, I actually killed myself, okay? Back in the 90s. I'm fine now, don't worry, I'm not down that road. I'm just telling you a story, okay? 93, things got so bad that I killed myself and had to be, you know, taken to hospital and stomach pumps and all kinds of horrible, nasty things, yeah? That's how bad it got. That's how sorry I was feeling for myself. And I was in this place where nobody understands me. The world is against me. This has gone wrong. That's gone wrong. I can't do anything right. And so on and so forth. Yeah, I have been there. I have been where you are right now. So I'm saying this from a position of love and caring. Yeah. But nobody told me that I had to get up and get on with it. People were very nice and very helpful. And what's wrong, Paul? And how can we help you? And all this kind of stuff, yeah? But what I needed was taking by the shoulders and shaking and saying, look, the reason why this person is doing so well is because of A, B, and C. That's what you need to understand. If you want to go where he is, then you've got to do the same kind of thing. And that's what I'm saying to you now. If you think your life is broken, it isn't. You're in a temporary situation, you're in a temporary dip, yeah? So we need to find your ladder, find the shovel, and build a big pile so you can climb out and move forward. So let's resume. Focus on the spot that isn't working. Focus on the part of your life that you think is broken. Take stock of your assets. List all your attributes, the things, your skills, your experience, your expertise, the stuff you've learned, okay? If it's a relationship thing, think about what you bring to the party. Think about the kind of person that you want to be with. Accept it. Don't hide from it. Okay, that's in the wrong order. It doesn't matter. Accept the situation and don't hide from it. Look at where you are right now, this moment, this present situation, and then think to yourself, what can I do to move forward one step? If you like, build yourself a roadmap. You know, get a piece of paper and draw a straight line. This is where you are right now. This is where you want to be. And then put in, I don't know, 3, 4, 5, 7 steps. And then start thinking about what steps you can take from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to your original destination. Now, I've written a straight line, but you could actually branch off because you find something here that's really interesting. So you move along there. Build yourself a roadmap. I can't do it for you. I can help you. I can coach you. I can mentor you. But in the end, when it comes down to it, only you can do this, okay? With some help and with some guidance. Stop looking to the future. You can't predict the future. All you can say is, that's where I want to be, that's my goal, that's where I'm going. And then get off your backside and take some action. Thank you for watching. My name is Paul. If you want to have a chat with me, just drop me a call me Paul in the comments or send me a DM. And I'll see you again soon. Bye.